always great to be here. This is the very first and only, the last one left, live wrestling television show in America. And it's great to be here. And today on USWA Championship Wrestling, we have an outstanding card. We have the Dirty White Boy schedule, the Wild Things, Rough and Tough Tag Team. Also, the Unified World Heavyweight Champion, the Snowman, will be here. We will have a match to determine who the number one contender to that crown is between Jerry the King Lawler and Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. Also on the program, the USWA tag titles are on the line as Joey Maggs and Rex King take on the new team that has made quite an impression, Primetime Brian Lee and his partner Don Harris. Also, we're going to be showing you a tape of a match that happened recently at the Coliseum, the Mid-South Coliseum in Memphis, Tennessee, with Tessa and the Dirty White Girl handcuffed in the corners of their respective teams. They got into it at the end of the match and a little bit more got exposed than what you would normally see, if you get my drift. We'll be getting all of this action and all the fun of USWA Championship Wrestling. First, let's take this break, and we'll be back with the action. The program right underway with wrestling action in the ring right now. The team of Deuce Mason and TD Steele.
You hear the music playing. Here they come, the Dirty White Boys, Tony Anthony and Tom Burton, accompanied with the Dirty White Girl, making their way to the ring right now. This match, one fall, 15-minute time limit. Referee Jerry Calhoun in the ring. We got the bell and we're ready for action. Tony Anthony going to start for his team up against Deuce Mason. Mason coming in, 218 pounds. Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony. Nice arm drag takedown by Mason. Dirty White Boy going right after him. I don't know if our television cameras can pick it up today, but across the way at ringside, in fact in the front row, are some very good wrestling fans, some friends of ours from the St. Peter's Villa here in Memphis, Tennessee. Boy, oh boy, nice kick by Tony Anthony. Anthony puts the headbutt on Mason. Mason goes down hard. It's always nice to have visitors from all over here at Championship Wrestling. Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony acting like a man possessed in the ring. Scoop slam going after Mason. Down he goes. Now we'll see Tony Burton. Take that, Tom Burton. Tom Burton recently has become more and more belligerent in the ring. I mean, he just takes it right to his opponent. And there you see it. T.D. Steele across the way trying to get the crowd into this one. But right now, Deuce Mason is taking a beating. And they want T.D. Steele in the ring. Tag is made. T.D., not much chance. As Tom Burton goes right after him. Burton, whoa! Takes him into the turnbuckle head first. Burton makes the tag. Dirty White Boy, the original Dirty White Boy, if you will. Tony Anthony returning to the ring. Snapmare on Steele. Going right after him with that knee. The Dirty White Boys are perhaps the toughest tag team in the USWA. I know we've got a lot of tough tag teams in the organization. But when it comes just to pure, rough, tough antics, I don't think there's a tag team that can match the Dirty White Boys. Anthony drops with the elbow, goes for the cover, gets a count of one. T.D. Steele out from under. There's a kick to the ribcage. Anthony quickly with the tag and out of the ring. He'll come. Tom Burton will return to the center of the square circle. Snaps him down with that brain buster. Puts the boot to the side of the head. T.D. Steele works for wear. Needs to make that tag out if he can. White Boys have completely dominated this match. Russian leg sweep by Tom Burton. Burton pounding away on Steele. Tag out quickly again. Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony back in, and look at that right hand from out of left field. Crowd beginning to chant. Hopefully hoping Steele will recover from this. I tell you, I think this man has taken a beating. Disposing of Deuce Mason. High knee lift by Tony. Anthony over in the corner. Tom Burton tags in. Picks up TDC. Oh, what could this be? Tag is made. What is this now? Tony Anthony, second strand of rope. Close line, and that could be it. Tony goes for the pin. Two, three, that's it. Showing a mean streak that runs so deep. Take the fall in the match over Deuce Mason and his partner T.D. Steele. Boy, the Dirty White Boys really showing what they are made of, and they are a tough, tough team. Let's take a break. More USWA wrestling action up after this. With you today on Championship Wrestling. Recently in Memphis, Tennessee, at the Mid-South Coliseum, a match occurred. Jerry the King Lawler teamed with superstar Bill Dundee with Tessa in their corner. They took on Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony and Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert with the Dirty White Girl in their corner. The girls were both handcuffed in their respective corners to the bottom strand of rope, to the bottom turnbuckle. But as the match progressed at the end, it sort of got out of hand and there was a little more flesh on the scene than what normally needed to be seen. We thought you wanted to see it. Here it is. Let's take a look. Our handcuff there. Bill Dundee with a high backdrop on the White Boy. Dundee climbing outside the ring, going to the top row. Meanwhile, Jerry the King Lawler has a chair propped up at ringside. Dundee comes down on the White Boy, and Gilbert's head is rammed into the chair.
Dundee tags out with Lawler. Lawler going up to the second rope. Levels the White Boy. Lawler firing off on Gilbert. Gilbert going through the ropes outside the ring. Lawler picks Gilbert up, throws him on the timekeeper's table. Lawler going over on the table. Dundee in there with a pin cover now. Referee Jerry Calhoun down on the canvas. Dundee with the pin cover. Count of one. Count of two. Jerry Calhoun shaking in there as Tom Burton out of nowhere comes climbing up in the ring. Look at this. And turns Dundee over on his back with a White Boy had his arm over the top of Dundee. And by the time Calhoun got back up on his feet, it looked to whereas Dundee had been pinned, Dundee that had Tony Anthony pinned.
Well, Lawler and Dundee saying, oh, look, that was Tom Burton that was out here. He's saying, Lawler's saying, look, he came from back there. You can't blame the referee. He called it like he saw it, but they're now discussing it. There's a lot at stake here tonight. The winner gets the unhandcuffed.
Star of the King, 110%. Lawler now gonna unhandcuff Tessa. Gets her unhandcuffed, and here she comes, the White Girl, squirming over here, trying to get out of that corner. That's Tom Burton, Eddie Gilbert, Tony Anthony, all up in the ring on Lawler and Dundee. Tessa makes her way over here to the corner, but Tony Anthony caught Tessa by the hair. Come on. This is too much. Tony Anthony going over there, handcuffing Tessa to the turnbuckle.
Man, I was afraid of something like this. With Tom Burton out here, they've got Lawler and Dundee planting the mat. The Dirty White Boy is going over and unhandcuffing the Dirty White Girl. This is a travesty here, to say the least. needs to get out here. Here comes Dirty White Girl. And Dirty White Boy just shoved Calhoun out of the way. And there goes the Dirty White Girl on Tessa with Dirty White Boy holding her. Lawler trying to keep her back. They're going to work on her. They're tearing away at her clothing over there. It looks like they've got part of her top off. I can't quite tell from here. Dirty White Girl ripping away. They pull down the top. She's got the top down.
The White Girl. After Tessa, Tony Anthony over there ripping the clothes off Tessa along with the White Girl. As Eddie Gilbert still working Dundee and Lawler over, along with Tom Burton, the other Dirty White Boy in there. The White Girl in there just beating on Tessa. Nails her with a fist in there. Tony Anthony just holding her over there as the White Girl slaps her around. Dundee turns around, trying to help out, but Tony Anthony holds her back. The White Girl really working Tessa over. Tessa in really bad trouble now.
Well, this has to be very humiliating for Tessa. And it's a shame it's happened like this. Dirty White Girl back out over on her. Ripping away. Eddie Gilbert going up the top rope to stop Lawler. Here comes Jeff Jarrett and Billy Travis to try to get him out of here.
There you can see what actually happened. I think the explanation was perfect. A travesty as to what occurred. Of course, the match being reversed and Lawler and Dundee being declared the winner, and they were really the winners to begin with. Let's see if we could get Jerry the King Lawler out here to talk about this and some of the events that have been happening here in the USWA, and I know he's going to have a lot to say. And here comes the King into the studio. And it is great to see him. I will tell you, he is fighting some battles, this man. And in that match, look at this. Jerry the King Lawler being greeted by many friends. And in this match, Jerry, before we get to talking
about... Wait a minute, I think I just got mugged here. Wait a minute.
Before we get to talking about this match, I said something earlier. Let me clarify.
Hey, my billfold's gone. No, I'm kidding.
This is the final live... This is not the final live television show, but it is the live television show that's in production in wrestling. I said earlier it was the final live television show, but it's not.
Oh, no, it's not like the last show.
No. I just wanted to clarify that. But I know you've had your hands full in this thing with the Dirty White Boys and Eddie Gilbert getting out of hand.
Well, you know, after watching that video, saying you have your hands full could be dangerous around here. It did get a little bit out of hand, but, you know, that was part of the stipulation. When you had the two girls handcuffed to each other, somebody was supposed to win the match and one get unhandcuffed and do whatever to the other one, and they each promised to rip the clothes off, rip the hair out. And so that's what we expected to see. The only problem was we won the match.
That's right.
It was clear to everybody. We won the match, but the problem was the wrong girl got unhandcuffed. And so this week we want to get that straightened out. I have a little piece of videotape from Bill Dundee and from Tessa, who are down in Texas today, and they had a little piece of videotape that they want. They got some special words that they wanted to say.
All right, but before we go to that, Jerry, let me ask you another question. Burton, Tony Anthony, and Eddie Gilbert, and the Dirty White Girl. Wait a minute, guys. We've had enough of this. We've had enough of this on TV in the past few weeks.
I'll say this. I used to give you a lot of credit for being smart, but after the last time here, I thought maybe you'd have the National Guard here with you or something. You didn't even bring any help. Dundee's off down in Texas with Tessa. That's the safest place for you to be. We're going to beat your brains out right here today, Lord. You ready, guys?
Wait a minute. We don't need any of this stuff. Holy cow! There's Dundee! Dundee's here with baseball bats! Holy cow! Tessa in the ring with the Dirty White Girl! Superstar Bill Dundee has two bombastic baseball bats, and he's going to town! For Tony Anthony, there's Lawler taking care of Eddie Gilbert, and the two girls in the ring. Look at Tessa and the Dirty White Girl! This is broken out into a melee! Holy Toledo! Superstar Bill Dundee came out of nowhere. Jerry Lawler said he was in Texas. The Dirty White Girl being helped out of the ring. Listen to Eddie Gilbert. He's yelling, trap, trap, trap. Holy cow. Bill Dundee supposedly in Dallas, Texas, and instead he shows up here at the television studio in the nick of time with a couple of baseball bats. And boy, talking about cleaning house.
Hey, let me tell you something. Gilbert, Dirty White Boys, I'm not the idiot that you guys take me for. Hey, I knew full well that you guys were going to do just exactly what you tried to do last week. You came out and you jumped me when you think I got no help. Well, brother, the king has got the superstar in Tessa with him today, and we're ready for you anytime. Like we said, this time when we get you in the ring, it's going to be a different story, because a little bit of a different stipulation this week is that not only is Tessa going to be handcuffed, not only is the Dirty White Girl going to be handcuffed, but so is Tom Burton, the other Dirty White Boy. He's going to be handcuffed too, so we don't have to worry about him. It's just Gilbert and Anthony and the King and the Superstar. And when we get through beating on you guys, we're going to go right over and we're going to unhandcuff Tessa. And believe me, she's going to do a number this week on the Dirty White Girl. Am I right or wrong?
You're right. Dirty White Girl, 2-on-2. Dundee and Lawler can beat anybody, anytime.
Tell them, baby, tell them.
And Tom Burton is not going to be a stipulation in this, because he's going to be handcuffed. Dirty White Girl's going to be handcuffed in the ring. I'm going to come tear every piece of your clothing off.
We want them all.
Nobody,
we want them all.
Nobody humiliates me like that.
There you go.
Tell him, Bill.
And let me tell you something, Anthea. You big and bad. I really think that little whore, I wish I could say that here, likes to be handcuffed. But the difference is, I don't know how much of a woman she got, but we're going to show it to everybody right here this week, because Burton, you handcuffed. And like the woman said, 2-on-2, this guy and this one here has been whooping everybody for the last 10 years, and it ain't going to change this week. We're going to see how much of a woman you are.
All right, I got to see that, man. Superstar Bill Dundee coming to the rescue just as it was needed. Let's clean up the studio. There are high heels in the ring. We'll be back with more wrestling action right after this. Came out here 3-on-1. You thought Lawler was alone. You had Trent just a few minutes ago.
We came out here to congratulate him on what a wrestler he is. That's what we came out here to do.
Yes, we did. Yes, we did. I don't know. With chairs and garbage cans, I don't buy
it. Well, we don't know sometimes what he's going to do to us.
Fans don't buy that.
Well, I don't care what they buy. I know what I buy, and I know in a Texas death match, gentlemen. See, I want you to know something, people. I want you to know something, Michael St. John. See, the Bill Dundee and Jerry Lawler that I just saw are the two men that as a kid Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert watched fight. They used anything they wanted to. Well, gentlemen, I wrote the book on fighting dirty, And this week in a Texas death match, you better bring your ball back, just like Tony Anthony said, because Hot Stuff is going to pull a few things out that everyone just thought might have went away. And wherever your king is, well, wait a minute. There's just still one more little thing left in there. Matter of fact, it's a big thing. We're talking about Tessa and the Dirty White Girl. And please, Dirty White Girl, I love what you did to her.
You know, Tessa, when the white girl makes a promise, I keep it. So this week, when they handcuff you to the ropes, put you in the ring and handcuff you to the ropes, and I come over there and I snatch that bleach blonde hair out of your head one more time and rip your clothes off and insult you like you've never been insulted before. Oh, and people, if you would, please bring some kind of a barf bag or something, because if you could see what I see close up, you'd be sick, too.
We'll see what happens in that match.
Well, won't you see what's going to happen right now? You get your king out here to the ring right now, and I'm going to show all of these people for free what I'm going to do to him today. Get him out here!
All right, let's get the match in the ring. Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert against Jerry the King Lawler. This will be for the number one contender for the USWA's Unified World Heavyweight Championship. Hot Stuff coming into the ring right now. The Dirty White Boys, Dirty White Girl leaving the area. And the King being accompanied by the lovely USWA ring girls in the ring. This match will be one fall. We have a scheduled 20-minute time limit of this one. Introducing the near corner out of Lexington, Tennessee, 222 pounds, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, and his opponent, Jerry the King Lawler, 232 out of Memphis, Tennessee. Referee Jerry Calhoun gives the signal for the bell, and we are ready. A very, very important match here on television today between Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Jerry the King Lawler. Winner of the match will get a shot at the Unified, actually will become the number one contender for the Unified World Heavyweight Championship. And Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, raising the ire of the crowd, he was about ready to lock up with the King and then rolled out of the ring, had second thoughts of locking up. Look at Gilbert. Gilbert telling referee Jerry Calhoun and tossing some comments over this way that he wants the crowd to shut up. And of course, Jerry the King Lawler wants them behind him, which they are. I can assure you, they lock it up finally. Gilbert side headlock. Lawler going to whip him to the ropes. Whoa, look at Gilbert. Look at Gilbert. Gilbert almost hung himself in the rope, trying to avoid that right hand of Lawler, which he anticipated was coming. And again, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert's on the floor. What's he doing? Now he's picked something up off the floor. This is one conniving wrestler. And I think I use that word very loosely. He will take any quarter possible and give none. And Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert right now avoiding the inspection of referee Jerry Calhoun. Lawler coming over to check out what's going on. When we talk about contenders, I'll have to say that either one of these men would make a very worthy opponent for Snowman, who is currently the Unified World Heavyweight Champion. Both men rough and tough with strong wrestling backgrounds. And of course, the legend of Jerry Lawler continues to grow with every match. And Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, as he alluded to earlier, had left the area and has returned. And since he has returned, he is after one thing and one thing only. And that's that Unified Heavyweight Championship, because he figures if he gets that, then he's sitting on top of the world, which indeed would be the case. Gilbert still hiding whatever he's got. Referee Jerry Calhoun searching it out. Now it looks like a piece of rope. He heard that. Not very happy with it. Gilbert's got it in his hand, keeping it at bay for now. He's going to lock up, it looks, again with Lawler. Lawler is very aware that Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert's got something, and indeed, there it comes. And now he's got Lawler wrapped up with that rope. Referee Jerry Calhoun in the corner, I don't think, quite realizes that Gilbert's using a foreign object in the ring. Lawler back to his feet. Gilbert going right after him, just choking. Blatant chokehold. Referee starts the count, has a count of three, count of four. Gilbert breaking at the last second, of course, DQ, disqualification coming on the count of five.
And those tough new USWA rules, that disqualification is not an easy thing to handle anymore. Going right in after Lawler again, trying to wear him down. Eddie Gilbert going right for the throat. One more time. Gilbert this time, right hand from right field. And boy, did Jerry Lawler get caught on the side of the jaw that time. Gilbert going to whip him into the buckle. Lawler moves out of the way. Eddie Gilbert, shoulder straight into the steel pole. Lawler going to whack him. And boy, oh boy, does he nail him. One more time for the hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert. Lawler now going after Gilbert. Choking him. Referee. Here comes the dirty white boys. White boys hitting the ring. Here comes the dirty white girl. White girl handing off something to hot stuff Eddie Gilbert. Referee calling for the bell. Outside interference. Dirty white. Oh, they're setting Lawler up. What could it be? Five. Oh, my goodness. Lawler gets out of the way. And hot stuff Eddie Gilbert just burned Tom Burton in the face. Lawler out of the ring. Downtown Bruno coming to ringside. Tom Burton writhing in pain on the floor. That fireball was intended for the king, Jerry Lawler. Lawler ducked out of the way, and Tom Burton caught it flush in the face. Tony Anthony has wrapped a towel around Tom Burton. The man is burning. My goodness, what a turn of events. Hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert just burned dirty white boy Tom Burton.
No, I didn't. That was Jerry Lawler's fire. Jerry Lawler just burned Tom Burton. I didn't do that! Jerry Lawler! Bill Dundee! Texas deathmatch! Anything goes! Lawler, you bring your fire! Dundee, you bring your bat! Bring your woman! Hot stuff will bring his fire! Tony Anthony will bring a chair! And the dirty white girl's gonna tear your clothes off, girl!
Oh boy! What a sudden turn of events here on Championship Wrestling! Getting wilder by the minute. Let's take a quick break. We'll be back with more action right after this.
Hi, this is Jerry Lawler at ringside, watching my friend Catherine Swisher preparing for the campaign trail in a race for Chancellor of Chancery Court Part 1. Catherine Swisher is an experienced trial litigator and has been practicing in Shelby County for more than 10 years. Honesty, integrity, knowledgeable, effective. A champion for all the people. On August the 2nd, vote Catherine M. Swisher, Chancellor, Chancery Court Part 1. Paid for by the committee to elect Catherine M. Swisher, Dr. E.E. Joe, Chairman.
Michael St. John back with you here on Championship Wrestling. I tell you, when Dave Brown leaves town, things get crazy around here, and I know it's crazy when Dave is here. Mid-South Coliseum Monday night, there is the Mighty Memphis Celebration continues, and we have got a great card on tap. Monday night, Mid-South Coliseum, it starts at 8 o'clock, opening action. Rex King takes on Scott Braddock. Then you'll see Joey Maggs, who is a sensational young star, made quite a name for himself here in the USWA, to take on Don Harris. Then a first blood match. Billy Joe Travis takes on Sweet Daddy Falcone of Devastation Incorporated, and the match doesn't end until somebody draws first blood. Then a big match. I know this man, or this person, I guess we should call him, has made quite a hit around the USWA, and he'll be at the Mid-South Coliseum Monday night. I'm talking about the Karate Turtle Cowabunga, and he'll face a very stiff test in the Missouri Tiger and Half of the Wild Thing and Jeff Gaylord. Then in a special challenge match, and you'll see what occurred to cause this match here in Memphis Monday night. We'll show it to you a little bit later on in the program. Jeff Jarrett will take on the Iceman King Parson. Then the Unified World Heavyweight Championship will be on the line as the Snowman takes on Primetime Brian Lee. That match for the Unified World title Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. And the main event, the fireworks and the fire flying about this one, Texas Tornado Deathmatch. Jerry the King Lawler and superstar Bill Dundee with Tessa handcuffed in the corner will take on hot stuff Eddie Gilbert and Tony Anthony. And this special stipulation, both the dirty white girl and Tom Burton will be handcuffed in their corner. So there won't be any interference from Tom Burton this week. And of course, this will be the Texas Tornado Death Match. And the winner of the match, one of the girls will be unhandcuffed from the winning team and will be in the ring. And goodness knows what will happen. If it was anything like last week, I think we'd better have the censors on hand. But anyway, all this action Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. Get out and see it. It's going to be a great
night of action starting at 8 o'clock. I want to call out Wayne Bright from Cool 101. He's going to talk to us about the Mighty Memphis Promotions Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum in conjunction with the wrestling. Wayne, good to see you again, buddy.
How you doing, Michael? How you doing?
You got that microphone? All right.
Monday night, it's Mighty Memphis Celebration. We're going to have giveaways to Memphis' finest restaurants. Mud Island passes to give away Libertyland, Graceland music from Pop Tunes, and as well as hot sporting events, Rockers games, Chicks games. We're going to have tickets for you Monday night. We're also going to kick off the Mr. USWA Hot Bodies Contest.
Whoa.
I understand we've got some of the guys here in the studio today.
Can we bring them out?
Yeah, we need to get them out here.
These are some of the gentlemen that will be participating. You can hear the reaction of the ladies in the crowd.
Now, we do stuff for the men all the time with the USWA ring girls, but this is for the ladies, right? We've got Sam Baker, Brian Burns, Carl Kanzler, and Big Tim. Now, if you'd like to get into the contest Monday night, all you have to do is come down to ringside and let us know. Come down to the table down there and say you want to be into the Mr. USWA Hot Bodies Contest. We've also got Bundy's Family Fun Section. Again, this week, if you bring your church bulletin, you get in for just $3 into the Bundy Family Fun Section. And right in line with the Mr. Hot Body Contest, if you're a member of a health club here in Memphis, you bring your card down there Monday night, your health club card, and you get in for just $3.
Wow, that's a deal.
Any health club.
Good deal.
A valid health club card. To bring the USWA ring girls out here now. They're going to be there Monday night. The USWA
ring
girls.
Now, I like this
girls.
Part myself.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is strictly for the men.
Thank you.
Strictly
my,
for the men.
My. Some very lovely ladies coming out to join us. Well, I tell you, you got the Hot Bodies Contest for the ladies, and
that's
you got
right.
The lovely ring girls for the men. You got a great card of wrestling action.
And we've got
prizes
Bundy
galore.
For the family fun section for the kids. Bundy will have prizes. I want to say that in the last couple of weeks, you know, the crowds have been getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. So I want to remind you to purchase your tickets early this week, and you can do so at all Ticketmaster locations.
Good
in
deal.
Fact, the Coliseum Ticket Office will be open until 5 p.m. today. Check out all the conventions or the Ticketmaster locations: Millington Naval Air Station, Downtown Convention Center, Park Place Mall, Southland Mall, and the Sound Shops at Hickory Ridge Mall, and the malls in Dyersburg, Jackson, and Oxford.
Well, we got all this going on at the Mid-South Coliseum Monday night, plus 7 great matches, including that Texas Tornado Death Match. And I don't want to say the fur is going to fly, but goodness knows what's going to happen in that. We have a Unified World Championship match. Jeff Jarrett's got a little score to settle
exactly.
In his match. First Blood match and much, much more. Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. Wayne, I hope to see you there.
Hey, I will be there. My Cool 101 bodyguard will be there. I want to mention, Monday morning between 6 and 10, we have got 8 tickets we're going to give away to wrestling. 4 pair of tickets. Tune in between 6 and 10 to Cool 101 Monday morning. And we got a new contest we're going to do this week.
All right. Now, all that coming up Monday night, Mid-South Coliseum. Hope you'll be there. Join us then. And let's take a break. We'll have more action right after this. Wrestling fans, before our break, we were talking about all the action at the Mid-South Coliseum Monday night. One of the things I want to do is bring out a man who's really got the opportunity of a lifetime going up against Snowman for the Unified World Heavyweight Championship. I'm talking about Primetime Brian Lee coming on the scene here in the USWA and getting a shot at the World Unified Heavyweight Championship Monday night in that big
first
card of action.
First of all, Michael, first of all, I want to tell all you ladies out there, this is the only body you really need to look at. Forget the other bodybuilders, huh? And I'm here for one reason. I'm here to visit this goof who sits in the audience. Called it. Give me the cord, idiot! Is this your champion? You know, you're right where you ought to be. You're right here with all these humanoids, and you see that beautiful belt? You better get one of these brothers with a stolen camera to take the picture, because that's the last time you're going to see it. Monday night in Memphis, you better strap it up tight. You better strap it up tight and dig down deep, because it's going for a gut check. Shut up, you bunch of idiots. Get out of my game.
Eddie Gilbert, or check that Eddie Marlin, checking what's going on over there in the corner. Promoter Eddie Marlin stepping in between Primetime Brian Lee and Snowman. Lee got to jump in the ring. We've got a match scheduled with the Snowman.
Get out of that ring!
And Chris Frazier.
Get out of the ring! Get him back in the back! Get back in the back!
You can hear what's going on with Eddie Marlin.
Get back in the
back! Trying to get
this.
Primetime Brian Lee back to his dressing room. Lee just getting the
Quite frankly, just getting carried away. We've got Chris Frazier out here ready for his match.
Get back in the background.
Come on, you nice though, man. You're going down. So take a good look at the belt.
All right, we're going to ring the bell. Promoter Eddie Marlin says, let's ring the bell. Let's get into it. Primetime Brian Lee going up against the Snowman Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. But the Snowman's got a little action to do right now on television here today, and that is Chris Frazier. Frazier in the ring. Snowman catches him. Double axe handle coming off the rope. Brian Lee has come back into the studio after being chased away by promoter Eddie Marlin. Eddie Marlin, primetime Brian Lee, look at the double underhook. Chicken wings him off.
He better count his days, Michael. He better count his days. If that's a so-called champion.
We'll see Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. Snowman will take on primetime Brian Lee for the title. But right now, Snowman making very quick work on the television today of Chris Frazier. Now he's going to send Frazier out of the ring. Snowman is incensed and has every right to be. Brian Lee. And here comes promoter Eddie Marlin again to step in between them one more time. There's some bad blood. Snowman going to go right after Brian Lee. Referee Jerry Calhoun stepping between them. Snowman going back after a chair. Let's see if we can get some things straightened out here. Let's go to this break. We'll be back with more wrestling action right after this on Championship Wrestling. Championship Wrestling getting ready now for the USWA Tag Team Championship match right here on television. I hear the music. That means Joey Maggs and Rex King are about to make their way into the ring. The defending USWA World Tag Team Champions. They'll be taking on the team of primetime Brian Lee and Don Harris. And that's a rugged team, but this match should be all the fireworks you could ever expect out of a title match right here on television. Championship Wrestling. Here they come. With a nice escort, I might add. Joey Maggs and Rex King, the USWA World Tag Team Champions. Proudly wearing those belts. They won so surprisingly, I might add. And now coming into the ring, Brian Lee and Don Harris. They're the challengers for the title here on television. This match will be one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing the challengers, a combined total weight of 493 pounds. Don and, well, let's do Brian Lee and Don Harris, okay? That's the way we're looking at them. Brian Lee and Don Harris. Their opponents, the USWA World Tag Team Champions, a combined weight, 463 pounds. Joey Maggs and Rex King. The belts are on the line here on television. One fall, 15-minute time limit. Referee Jerry Calhoun trying to get one man from each team in the ring. And we are ready. The title defense is on Championship Wrestling. Right. Brian Lee asking the crowd to refrain from yelling. That's not going to happen here on television, I can tell you that. Rex King will start for his team, decked out in the purple trunks. Joey Maggs in the corner in the hot pink with Hot Shot written behind. Brian Lee talking to his partner, Don Harris. And Brian Lee goes right to work on Rex King. The martial art action is, oh, look at that. Primetime Brian Lee just going over in the corner and caustically spitting in the direction of Joey Maggs. And that caused Joey to be irate. And noticeably so. Look at that, he does it again. Maggs gonna head back into the ring. Look at that, in the meantime, Rex King goes to town on both Don Harris and primetime Brian Lee. High drop kick, double drop kick. Maggs connecting on Lee. Both men out of the ring to try to recuperate from that. Conversing on the floor, primetime Brian Lee with Don Harris. Except that chair has been the worst for wear today here on Champion.
Concentrate with all these idiots out here yelling, shut up, you bunch of goons!
Primetime Brian Lee has done nothing on Championship Wrestling to endear himself to the fans. And that little outburst, I think, coming as a result of being frustrated over The series of drop kicks delivered by Joey Maggs and Rex King. Tag has now been made. Don Harris will enter the ring. Harris has been quite impressive since coming on the scene in the USWA. And they're quite a tag team partner with primetime Brian Lee. They lock it up, collar and elbow. Rex King going in, arm twist, going to make the tag, and we'll see hot shot Joey Maggs. Got a double arm twist and a double chop, and down goes Don Harris. Harris caught by Joey Maggs. Tag has made. Rex King coming in. King and Maggs both at a disadvantage from a height standpoint and a weight standpoint in this match, but they do own the USWA World Tag Team Championship, that is. And the thing about it is, when you see two wrestlers of this magnitude and this stature, a lot of the bigger teams will right away challenge for the belt, thinking that the strength and the height and weight advantage can take the best of Rex King and Joey Maggs. But I can assure you, in the case of King and Maggs, this team is becoming more and more finely tuned as a tag team each and every week on Championship Wrestling. King ducks out of the way, catches Brian Lee, catches him the second time with the arm drag. Lee retreating to the safety of the ropes, and now down on the floor again, and quickly Don Harris going to drop out of the ring area with him and converse as they'll try to recoup. Primetime Brian Lee and Don Harris may have underestimated the prowess of the USWA World Tag Team Champions. At least the way the match has gone thus far, the champions have had things pretty much going their way. Brian Lee now wanting to shake hands with Rex King. The crowd advising Rex not to have any part of it. And to be honest with you, I wouldn't either, and that's the exact reason. Primetime Brian Lee distracting Rex King just enough, and then moves right in. Now going to pull him over in his corner. Don Harris coming in, puts one to the midsection. Now a bolo chop to the back, and Rex King taking some punishment. Whip to the rope, and Harris catches him with that clothesline. That was the mid part of the forearm, and Rex King got it right under the chin. That is a very dangerous maneuver. And could literally swallow a ton when that maneuver is delivered. Body slam by Harris on King, coming off the ropes, going to drop the elbow, but Rex King moves out of the way. King staggered in the ring, trying to regain his composure, indeed does, and makes the tag, and hot shot Joey Maggs hits the ring. Fifth of line. There's one for Brian Lee. There's one for Harris. All four men in the ring, and appear sixes right now. Referee Jerry Calhoun with his hands full of trying to restore some order. Brian Lee drops to the floor, comes in the ring. He's got a chair with him. There's a roll-up by Maggs. Primetime Brian Lee just nailed Joey Maggs in the back. Harris rolls him up. One, two, three. Did he get the pin? He got the pinfall. And in a wild upset, Primetime Brian Lee and Don Harris have gained the USWA World Tag Team Championship with some heavy metal help of a heavy metal chair on the back of Joey Maggs. Referee Jerry Calhoun conversing with Rex King, now going to go over and talk to Primetime Brian Lee. He's asking about that chair. The fans are telling him about the chair. We could have a reversal here. Let's see what it's going to be. Jerry Calhoun's got the bounce back, and he has awarded the match. He has reversed the decision and awarded the match to Joey Maggs and Rex King. But now Lee and Harris are going after him, attacking him from behind. King whipped. Joey Maggs being attacked by Don Harris. Maggs caught in the corner. Rex King is down. Both men home. Double clothesline. The champions being battered in the ring by Primetime Brian Lee and Don Harris. Promoter Eddie Marlin is out. Now they're pounding him with the belt. Hot shot Joey Maggs being pounded by the belt as Brian Lee and Don Harris quite upset by the reversal, but it was just and due. They should have never used the chair in the match. The champions, Rex King and Joey Maggs. We'll have to see what becomes of this. Primetime Brian Lee and Don Harris being asked to leave the ring area. The The champions retaining their belts, Rex King and Joey Maggs, but are the worst for wear in the ring. We'll get that attended to, and we'll be back to more action right after this. Besides all the action here at the television studio at Channel 5 and Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum in Memphis with those seven big matches, there's action all over the Mid-South. We want to run it down for you real quick. Let's first go to Osceola, Arkansas this next Saturday. This next Saturday at 8 o'clock at the Junior High in Osceola. Jerry Lawler, Superstar Bill Dundee with Tessa, the Dirty White Boys with the Dirty White Girl, Snowman, Jeff Gaylord, Battle Royal. Tickets are on sale at Sissy's Donuts in Osceola, Arkansas. That is next Saturday night at 8 o'clock. Also next Saturday night in Alamo, Tennessee, National Guard Army, Jeff Jarrett will be there along with Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, Cowabunga, the Karate Turtle, special ladies match coming up in Alamo, Tennessee next Saturday. Tickets will be on sale, of course, that day. We have matches next Saturday at 3 o'clock at Airport Toyota here in Memphis. Jerry the King Lawler, Snowman, Cowabunga, Jeff Gaylord, Scott Braddock, Ken Wayne, and many more stars at Airport Toyota. That's next Saturday. It's June 28th at 3 o'clock. Be sure to see those matches at Airport Toyota. Hall, Tennessee, action coming your way on August 3rd at 8 o'clock. You can get a dollar off advance tickets. USWA Wrestling coming to Hollis. Also in Lawrenceburg, Tennessee, on Thursday, August 9th at the Rotary Park Building, you'll see USWA action in Lawrenceburg, Tennessee. Trenton, Tennessee, on Friday, August 10th at the National Guard Armory. $1 off advance tickets in Trenton. Jackson, Tennessee, Sunday, August 12th, 8 o'clock. Jeff Jarrett will be in Jackson with Jerry the King Lawler Superstar Bill Dundee, a special ladies match, all at Broncos in Jackson, Tennessee on Sunday, August 12th. Boonville, Mississippi, the USWA heads your way. City Park on Friday, August 17th. Jerry the King Lawler will be in Boonville along with Superstar Bill Dundee. Dollar off advance tickets in Boonville also. Jonesboro, Arkansas. Now, you know, they closed the old building a few weeks ago, but we're coming back to Jonesboro in a brand new building. We want to see all our fans in Jonesboro. Coming your way on Saturday, August the 25th at the Earl Bell Community Center. Now, that's on Church Street, and a lot of USWA stars will be there. The USWA returning to Jonesboro, Arkansas, a brand new building. That'll be on Saturday, August the 26th at the Earl Bell Community Center. And we'll hope to see all our fans there. And coming soon, USWA wrestling to Senatobia, Mississippi. I want to remind you, tomorrow afternoon, a special softball game as Lawler's Army will take on the Tri-County All-Stars. That will be in Bolivar, Tennessee, and this is going to be one fun football game, but actually it's a softball game. Bolivar, Tennessee tomorrow, Lawler's All-Stars will take on the, Lawler's Army, rather, take on the Tri-County All-Stars. Hope to see all our USWA wrestling fans at Bolivar tomorrow afternoon. Let's take a break. We'll have more wrestling action right after these messages. Michael St. John here with promoter Eddie Marlin has joined me. An event, Eddie, that has that happened here in Memphis a month or so ago has sort of become contagious throughout the wrestling world, and I've asked you to come out here and explain to the fans what happened.
I'd just like to explain to the fans the reason I was so hard on Snowman, because something like this happens, it just opens the door. I've got nothing against Snowman, but the way he came back in, it just opens the door to all of the wrestlers all over the world. It's been barred from certain wrestling organizations. And now we had this incident that came up in Dallas, and I just wanted the people to know that's the reason I was so hard on Snowman. I'm not against him, but I'm against the ways that things happen like this.
Well, you know, it does become a contagious effect, and what we'll
just show the tape. They'll know what we're talking about.
All right, let's take a look at the tape. This happened in Dallas, Texas, an incident involving Iceman King Parsons. Let's take a look.
Well, Gary Young, Sweet Daddy Falcone, and yeah, you, Akbar. Y'all just come on down to that ring, because I know one thing. I got another figure four for all three of you guys.
I know nothing, boy. I don't know nothing. I ain't going nowhere.
You're not even in this organization.
Get your hands off me, man. Hey.
And they got punks like you, and they're working in the main event, baby.
You don't have any business.
told you, don't touch me, white man. You know what's going on. You don't have any business here. You had yourself in USWA.
I got business here.
I got right here just like anybody else.
You don't have any business here. You're not in the contract with USWA.
I want to right there.
Just in the time and place to do it. You have every opportunity to come to my office.
Man, look, hey, don't, I told you, don't grab on me, man.
Don't
grab
on me. You don't have any business here.
Hey, man, let me tell you something like you know.
Hey, you don't have any business here at all. You had that whole thing. You came to the USWA.
I want to talk to you.
Oh, I tell you, you don't have any business here. Properly. Jeff
Jared talking to matchmaker John Brazell as they escort Iceman King Person. Let me go up here.
Jeff Jarrett threatening to quit there after the intrusion by Iceman King Parsons, says he can wrestle him anywhere Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. Jeff Jarrett is going to get that chance. He had some comments for championship wrestling. Let's hear from Jeff Jarrett.
You know, the first thing I want to say is I want to thank the USWA, the promotion, for giving me this match. And then the next thing I want to get across is to you people. The reason I insisted on this match, that I demanded that I have the match, is because of Iceman King Parsons. He comes out, and he rants and he raves, and yeah, he wasn't even scheduled, and he's talking about this guy and that guy, and he's running down USWA. He's saying that he can't get booked to wrestle here and there. But Iceman, the thing that you did do was that you jumped me, that you tried to humiliate me, that you tried to make a name. Yeah, and you do got a name. I know, Iceman. You've been all across the country, and you were the first black world heavyweight champion down in Texas, and you've held every belt there is down in Texas. But you're fixing to come into this area, Iceman, and you're not going to make a name on me. Because what I think you are, Iceman, is a big bag of hot air, and that's all you know how to do. So, Iceman, when you walk down the aisle this week, I'm going to walk down the other aisle, and we're going to find out just how big and bad and how tough you are. So, Iceman, you better get ready, because I got something for you.
We got more wrestling action coming up here on Championship Wrestling, but before we get to it quickly, let's run down the card for the Memphis Mid-South Coliseum Monday night. Mighty Memphis Celebration continues. Action starts at 8 o'clock. Opening match, Rex King takes on Scott Braddock. Joey Maggs meets Don Harris. In a first blood match, Billy Joe Travis takes on Sweet Daddy Falcone of Devastation Incorporated. Then the Karate Turtle, Cowabunga, meets Jeff Gaylord, one of the Wild Things. In a special challenge match, you just saw what happened in Texas to cause this match. Jeff Jarrett will take on Iceman King Parsons in that special challenge match Monday night at the Coliseum. Unified World Heavyweight Championship match, Snowman ready for action, and so is Primetime Brian Lee. He's pumped up. The Snowman's pumped up. That's going to be a wild affair Monday night. And the main event, a Texas Tornado death match. Falls don't count. Jerry the King Lawler and superstar Bill Dundee will take on Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony. And here's the special stipulation. The Dirty White Girl and Tony Burton, and Tom Burton, rather, will be handcuffed to the lower strand of rope in the corner of Gilbert and the White Boy. And Tessa will be handcuffed in Lawler and Dundee's corner. And some birds going to fly, I'll tell you, because the winning team gets done handcuffed there, lady. And then after that, goodness knows what will happen. All that Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. Let's bring Wayne Bright back in here very quickly to talk about the Mighty Memphis Celebration and everything else that's going to be going on Monday night at the Coliseum. Wayne?
Monday night is the Mighty Memphis Celebration. Hey, we've got tickets to Memphis' finest restaurants, Graceland passes, Libertyland passes. We've also got the Bundy Family Fun section. And if you bring a valid health club card this week, you get in for just $3 to the gold load seats. Now, the reason this is, we're having the Mr. USWA Hard Body Contest. If we can get the guys to come back out here once again. You know, we've had the USWA Ring Girls for several weeks.
Right, right.
For the men. Now we've got something especially for the ladies. Ladies, you're going to want to see this. Mr. USWA Hard Body Contest this Monday night. Now, these are just a few of the guys that are going to be in the competition Monday night. If you'd like to get into the competition, just come down to the table at ringside, sign up, and you'll be in the competition. And we're going to let the fans do sort of like decide who is going to be Mr. USWA Hardbody.
Something very special for the ladies Monday night at the Coliseum.
That's it. Also, we have for the men, we've got the USWA Ring Girls. They are going to be down there Monday night. You don't want to miss this. The Hardbodies for the ladies from the men, and for the men, the USWA Ring Girls.
Can I just take these with me and you get some new ring girls? Never mind.
We better keep them here. Of course, Monday morning, we're going to have free wrestling tickets for you on Cool 101. And you can get your wrestling tickets now at all Ticketmaster locations until 5 o'clock today at the Coliseum Box Office.
Plus 7 big matches. Don't miss a minute of it. Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum. We'll see you there. Thank you very much, Wayne. We're going to call out real quick Jeff Gaylord, if you would. The Missouri Tiger, of course, one half of the Wild Things. He's got a big match coming up, and he, I'm sure, is going to want to talk about all the matches that he's been involved with. I know one of the matches he's been involved with is the Karate Girl, Cowabunga. And here comes Big Jeff now, accompanied with Downtown Bruno, and here comes Scott Braddock, the Wild Things, if you would.
Hey, let me tell you something. This week, I'm on a little hunt.
A little hunt, yeah, tell him, Jeff.
Let me tell you about the hunt I'm on. I'm hunting turtles.
Turtles, that's right.
Because at my house in my room, I got a trophy room.
You ought to see how big his trophy case is.
I've got bears, deer, snakes, and now I'm going to have a turtle head in my turtle room. Because when I get a hold of Cowabunga, I'm going to tear his head off.
Tear his head off, Jeff.
Tear it right off, and I'm going to carry it home. And we're going to put it in my trophy room.
In that big trophy room.
Big trophy room. And then I will show everybody who the supreme being is.
Tell them the supreme
the Wild Things, baby.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah.
All right, Mr. Wild Thing, Mr. Bruno, I've got a question for you. Your man right here agreeing with everything you said last week. The Cowabunga Karate Turtle sort of did a number on your
head. No, this is what happened. Scott had food poisoning. He was sick for 3 days. He lost 20 pounds, did he, Bruno?
20 pounds.
Came from the hospital room to try and wrestle. He was only at 1% of his strength.
Kill him, Jeff.
So that was the reason for that. Scott just wasn't 100%. He was only 1%.
But you're 100%.
Oh, I'm 120%. I can't wait to get my new trophy.
Right. Let's see what Cowabunga has to say about this. Let's see what Cowabunga says.
Oh, Jeff Gaylord the Great. Look at those muscles, dude. Totally awesome. Oh, Beverly Hillbillies.
Gnarly.
Oh, the boulders are beautiful. All right, dude. Oh, gnarly. That's no good, dude.
Like we're standing up.
Oh, totally bodacious. Dude, what a babe.
Compliment your shit.
Oh, bogus, dude. Oh, wrestling's on. All right, wrestling, professional wrestling. Oh, totally radical, dude. In a case, that's Jerry the King Lawler. All right, awesome. All right, Jerry the King. Get him, Your Highness. Come on, get him, dude. All right.
Cowabunga.
Oh, master, master. I'm watching Jerry on TV. I'm watching the King.
Cowabunga, say no.
All right.
My master's first rule was possess the right thinking. You are about to face your most difficult battle in a fight against evil. Gaylord the Great, he is as Mount Fuji, tall, strong, powerful, and cold. You must learn to strike hard and fade away without a trace.
Just like we said, nobody beats the Wild Things, not no turtle, not nobody.
We'll see. We'll go to the match right now in the ring. The Wild Things up against their opponents. Let's ring the bell, referee Jerry Calhoun calling the bell to action. That's right.
Wild Things, brother, is Jeff Gaylord and Scott Braddock. The only thing wild is going to be Ben Jordan's imagination, because he's going to get his brain knocked out, like you just saw. Downtown Bruno does not associate with losers. And what you see here are time champion. Champions without the belt. I'm going to tell you something. USWA Tag Team Championship is on its way to the new downtown connection. I'm talking about the Wild Thing. I don't care, Rex King. I don't care, Joey Mack, how good you are, what kind of team you are, when you finally put them titles on the line against the Wild Thing, along with downtown good-looking Bruno, you're going to be ex-champion. They might call you Chance for short, but not for long, believe that. And I've also got a message. I hope Jerry the King Lawler is watching this match, because Lawler said a lot of negative things about me, a lot of nasty things about me. He accused me of things I didn't do. Well, brother, downtown Bruno doesn't take any accusations lightly. And the Wild Things will do the same thing to you, brother, that they're doing right here to Ken Raper. I guarantee you. It's like Mama says, it bees that way sometimes.
Jeff Gaylord off that top rope onto Raper. This could be it right here and now. One, two, three. The Wild Things take it. Taking quick action of Ben Jordan and Ken Raper, the Wild Things in the ring. Jeff Gaylord and Scott Braddock with Downtown Bruno. Let's take a break. We'll have more right after this. We're out of time, fans. We'll see you Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum and next week right back here for Championship Wrestling. So long.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.
It's USWA Wrestling Excitement Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. Six fantastic matches. Opening up, Don Harris takes on Dirty White Boy Tom Burton. Then we'll see Joey Mag in action against Wild Thing Scott Braddock with Downtown Bruno in his corner. Primetime Brian Lee battles Rex King. In a special challenge match in Evansville Wednesday night, the Karate Turtle Cowabunga meets Wild Thing Jeff Gaylord with Downtown Bruno in his corner. A special explosive match. Falls will count anywhere in the building. It's simply irresistible Jeff Jarrett meeting the challenge of the Iceman King Parson. And the main event, Texas Deathmatch, falls do not count. Jerry the King Lawler teams with superstar Bill Dundee with Tessa in their corner to take on Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony with the Dirty White Girl accompanying them in their corner. Don't miss a minute of the action Wednesday night in Evansville.
I can see it now. People out there in TV land and all over the country asking, why is such a good-looking man like Primetime Brian Lee doing back in a territory like this? Well, competition. The competition's better, so I'm back. First of all, Rex King. I've beat you, boy, like a dog 100 times in every Coliseum we've met in. And now you want to sign another match with me? I've already ran your boy off that you tagged with, and now you're going to go in a match with me single? I'm 6'6", 280 pounds, and I don't play. I'll brush you off like a fly, boy. And another thing, you, Jeff Jarrett, Goldilocks, Akbar's paying big, big money. And that's just what I am. Primetime Brian Lee's about big money. So watch your back, Jeff. Left shoulder, right shoulder, or maybe just straight ahead.
It's USWA Wrestling Excitement Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. Six fantastic matches. Opening up, Don Harris takes on Dirty White Boy Tom Burton. Then we'll see Joey Mag in action against Wild Thing Scott Braddock with Downtown Bruno in his corner. Primetime Brian Lee battles Rex King. In a special challenge match in Evansville Wednesday night, the Karate Turtle Cowabunga meets Wild Thing Jeff Gaylord with Downtown Bruno in his corner. A special explosive match. Falls will count anywhere in the building. It's simply irresistible Jeff Jarrett meeting the challenge of the Iceman King Parson. And the main event, Texas Deathmatch, falls do not count. Jerry the King Lawler teams with superstar Bill Dundee with Tessa in their corner to take on Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony with the Dirty White Girl accompanying them in their corner. Don't miss a minute of the action Wednesday night in Evansville. It's USWA Wrestling Excitement Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. Six fantastic matches. Opening up, Don Harris takes on Dirty White Boy Tom Burton. Then we'll see Joey Mag in action against Wild Thing Scott Braddock with Downtown Bruno in his corner. Primetime Brian Lee battles Rex King. In a special challenge match in Evansville Wednesday night, the Karate Turtle Cowabunga meets Wild Thing Jeff Gaylord with Downtown Bruno in his corner. A special explosive match. Balls will count anywhere in the building. It's simply irresistible Jeff Jarrett meeting the challenge of the Iceman King Parson. In the main event, Texas Death Match, balls do not count. Jerry the King Lawler teams with superstar Bill Dundee with Tessa in their corner to take on Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony with the Dirty White Girl accompanying them in their corner. Don't miss a minute of the action Wednesday night in Evansville.
General Akbar, I'm talking to you, because you're something in wrestling that I think that the whole organization of wrestlers need to get rid of, and that's managers. Because all you are is a big leech. You leech on the guys, and you hang on their coattails, and you pump them full of information and tell them that they're the greatest and that they're going to make all kinds of money. And really, the truth of the matter is you're a big stinking liar. Now, Akbar, over the last couple of months, it seems like every title shot I get, and that world title, that's the belt that I'm going after in one day. I don't care who the champion is, if it's the Snowman, Jerry Lawler, or whoever it may be at the time. One day I'm going to get that world title. But Akbar, it's guys like you that keep me from getting belts and keep me from getting title shots and winning tag matches or whatever it may be. Well, you just bring whoever you want out of Devastation Incorporated, and I'm going to take care of them.
Before we close out the program today on Championship Wrestling, I want to call in Jerry the King Lawler. He's involved in a very big dispute with Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony, Tom Burton, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. I don't know how many people they're going to put in their corner.
Well, let me just say this is twice now that Eddie Gilbert and Tony Anthony, I accuse them of sending boys to do a man's job. I guess by now, Eddie Gilbert, you realize that it's going to take more than what you got to do in the King and the Superstar. Now, you thought that you had a couple of chumps here that you were going to be able to run roughshod over. Well, you're seeing right now that it's going to take a little bit more thinking, a little bit more preparation, a little bit more intestinal fortitude than maybe you possess to get rid of me and Bill Dundee. Well, let me tell you something. They challenged us to a Texas Tornado death match. Well, that's all you got to do is ask or issue a challenge, because Dundee and I are ready to accept, and that's what it's going to be this week. And I don't know if you guys know what you're biting off, because a Texas Tornado death match involves some pretty heavy stipulations. You see, that means that falls don't count. That means if a man gets pinned, tough beans, brother. All you do is you give him a 30-second rest period, and then he gets up and you keep on going. And you go until somebody is not able to get up, until somebody's not able to continue. And anything goes in one of these matches. There won't be any disqualifications or technical losses if somebody picks somebody up in a pile driver and drives their head right to the mat. You just keep on going if you can. And another thing, they won't be stopping the match for any reason. I don't care if somebody's bloody from head to toe. I don't care if he needs a transfusion on the spot. I don't care if he needs to be in a hospital or somebody's bones are broken and sticking through the skin. They're not going to stop it. You just go and go until somebody can't continue. And when that finally happens, Eddie Gilbert and Dirty White Boy, when somebody finally can't continue, then the match is declared over. And only then. And Bill Dundee and I plan on being the ones that are left standing. We plan on seeing one of you two jerks put on a stretcher and carried out of the ring. And when all that's over, we're going to take the key to that handcuff. And we're going to walk over and we're going to unlock Tessa's handcuffs. And then they're going to take the Dirty White Girl and they're going to put that little tramp right in the middle of that ring. But, oh yes, she's going to still be handcuffed to the rope, just like Tessa was last week. And then she's going to do a number on that Dirty White Girl. You know, she comes around. She likes to strut her stuff. She likes to try to tease everybody and show a little bit of skin. Well, skin is in for the 90s. And we're going to see a lot of it this week, because Tessa has assured us that when she gets through pulling all of your hair out, she's going to pull every stitch of clothes off of you. And I'm looking forward to seeing that myself. So, Superstar Dundee and the King, we're ready. And I can assure you Tessa's ready. Tony Anthony, Eddie Gilbert, you and the Dirty White Girl had better just ask yourself, are you ready? All I can tell you is, You better be, because it's going to happen this week sooner than you think.
One of the world's most dangerous matches, the Texas Tornado Death Battle. Superstar Bill Dundee teaming with Jerry the King Lawler to take on Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony and Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. That is a rugged team. In the corners, handcuffed in respective corners, Dirty White Girl in the corner of Anthony and Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. And, of course, Tessa in the corner, handcuffed to the ropes of Jerry the King Lawler and Superstar Bill Dundee. And I'll tell you, I wouldn't want to be in Tony Anthony's shoes, and I certainly wouldn't want to be in Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert's shoes. But more importantly, Tessa has got something not only to prove, but something to get even with the young Dirty White Girl. And when they're in the middle of the ring, goodness knows what will happen. They'll just lock it up, and they'll go to town. And I hope you've got a strong stomach and perhaps even binoculars to see this match. We're out of time on Championship Wrestling. We'll see you next week for all the exciting action of USWA Championship Wrestling.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.